There may be times where audio from one source needs to override audio from a different source, or the venue requires that an analog signal backs up a digital signal for redundancy purposes in case of a transmission path failure. In these situations, you may want to configure the priority input routing of a DCI network series amp using Audio Architect software. To access the priority input routing section, double-click on the image of the amplifier to open up the default device panel. Next, double-click on the input icon for the channel you wish to work with, in this example, channel 1. The input source routing window appears. If you are not familiar with this window, it is recommended you watch the previous videos which detail both analog and BlueLink input routing. Notice that there are three different priority sources, high, medium, and low. Each priority level can be configured to a different source. In this example, I will configure the high priority to analog input 1, which I have connected to a music source. I will assign the medium priority input source to BlueLink channel 1, which I have previously assigned to a pink noise generator, and the low priority input source to BlueLink channel 2, which I have assigned to a white noise generator. For more information on BlueLink routing, see the video titled Input Routing BlueLink. To access the configurable settings for the priority input router, click on the small arrow to the right side of the input source routing window to expose the controls. You will now see controls for threshold, attack time, release time, and depth of cut. The attack time is the amount of time it takes for this priority, when activated, to switch in. The release time is the amount of time it takes for this priority, when deactivated, to switch to the next priority level. The depth of cut determines how much to cut the signal losing priority. Only in very rare instances would the depth of cut need to be changed from the default negative 100 dB setting. If you are unsure how to configure any of these settings, it is recommended you use the default values. The threshold for each priority level indicates that the assigned input source will be routed to the output as long as the input source level is above the threshold value. As you can imagine, the input with the highest priority that meets the threshold parameter is the input that will be routed to the output. In this case, since my music on analog input 1 is above its threshold, negative 80 dB, and is the highest priority, this input is active. Even though the pink noise and white noise on the medium and low priorities are above their threshold, negative 60 dB, they are not active because the parameters for a higher priority have been met. Notice that as I lower the level of the music, it still stays active, even when I move below negative 60 dB. This is because the threshold setting for the high priority is still met, and will be until the level dips below negative 80 dB. As I lower the music below negative 80 dB, the active input quickly switches to the medium priority, pink noise. The pink noise signal level is above its threshold value, negative 60 dB, and no higher priority parameters are met. This medium priority input will be active until its threshold value is no longer met at below negative 60 dB. As soon as I lower the signal below negative 60 dB, the medium priority pink noise signal is no longer active, and the low priority white noise signal is activated. The low priority signal will be active until either the high priority or the medium priority signal exceeds their threshold value. Notice that as I raise the medium priority pink noise signal level to exceed negative 60 dB, it becomes the active signal. As I raise the high priority music signal level to exceed negative 80 dB, it becomes the active signal. Once you have the priority input routing set up properly, don't forget to store your settings. Thank you for watching this video. For questions, comments, or suggestions regarding this or any other video, please send them to the email address shown below. For technical assistance, please call the technical support department or email them at the options shown below.